And then this week, the Senate stepped up, united as we seldom do these days, to talk about the veterans of that war and our other wars and the obligation we have to our veterans. I think the bill that the Senate passed yesterday that I co-sponsored and that I vote for can be better, and I think, frankly, it will be better after we get a chance to have a conference with our House colleagues, maybe even a conference like conferences used to be. It's time we got back to the normal way of doing business. But the underlying approach, this key significant change that the bill that the Senate passed yesterday brings to the veterans is more options and more opportunities. And particularly our younger veterans, Mr. President, want to see more choices. They want to have more information. When Senator Stabenow and I sponsored last year, and actually when we initially put the bill forward in early 2013, the Excellence in Mental Health Act, the Iraq and Afghanistan veterans were among our greatest supporters, along with law enforcement, along with the mental health community, for an act that they thought had the potential to provide more options for treatment, more places to go, more ways to get, in that case, the mental health treatment and access that you'd like to have, that worked with family, that worked with jobs. These are young veterans who've left the military but still have lots of obligations that they want to and need to and should be trying to fulfill to themselves, their family, the work they have chosen to do. The assistance we can give them with more options is important, but we're seeing in this bill an opportunity for all veterans to have more options if the Veterans Administration fails to meet their needs in an appropriate way, and for many veterans to have options if they just simply don't live near a veterans facility. That 40-mile standard, that standard where if you're further away than an hour or so, even in any way you measure traffic and time from a veterans facility, you would permanently have the ability to get your care as a veteran at any facility that accepts Medicare patients at that Medicare rate. That would be the reimbursement rate for the government and the VA to pay. And for veterans, even if you live next door to a VA hospital, if that hospital couldn't see you within the time that the law will ultimately decide is the critical time, and by the way, for some occasions, the critical time is right now. A heart attack, a veteran contemplating suicide, there's no waiting period that's acceptable for either of those or anything like that. But for routine medical care, an acceptable waiting period would be determined. We've been talking about 14 days. If you can't be seen in 14 days, you get the card that says you can go wherever you want to go. I hope that's the way this final bill works out so that veterans have lots of options. I think the Veterans Administration is going to be better if they have to compete. And I've thought that for a long time. And I was at the Truman Veterans Facility as I stand here at one of the desks that Harry Truman used when he was in the Senate and his name is carved in the desk drawer. I was at the Truman Veterans Facility in Columbia, Missouri, and my good longtime friend Dewey Ream, who's advised me for a long time on these veterans issues with the VFW, the head of their legislative effort in our state, we were meeting with the people that run that hospital, and Dewey Ream said, you know, Senator Blunt's been saying for at least 10 years we need to have more options for veterans, and I'm here today saying I think he's been right in that discussion, even though our defenders and advocates of the veterans hospitals and the veterans system wanting to make it better have been slow to embrace the idea of more options for veterans, but they're there now, and the Congress is there now, and this system will be better because veterans will have more choices. And there are some things, Mr. President, that the Veterans Administration clearly, if they're not better than anybody else at those things, we need to ask why. Injuries that would be the result of IEDs, explosive attacks, they should be better at dealing with those eye injuries and loss of limb and rehabilitation than anybody else in America. They should be better at post-traumatic stress than anybody else in America dealing with that. But there's no particular reason that they're going to be better at dealing with cancer. or dealing with a heart problem, or dealing with a lung issue. There's no reason to believe that at all. And this is a time to really rethink what's best, not for the Veterans Administration, but what's best for the veterans. Our goal here should be what's the best thing for the veteran, not what's the best thing for the Veterans Administration. And we've all seen the list, and too many Missouri facilities are too high on that list of waiting too long to get service. We've all seen those lists. We've all heard the stories of supervisors at one facility after another, and I'm sure not every facility, telling the people they supervise, here's how we're going to manage the people that want to be here so that it appears we're doing a better job than we're doing. We've had enough of that. Enough appearing to be doing a better job than we're doing. Now is when we need to insist that that better job be done. And I think we took a big step in that direction yesterday. I look forward to this bill improving as the House and Senate work together now to bring their two bills to a final vote, to go on the president's desk, to be signed into law to change the way we deal with veterans.